Good day, everyone. Connor McIver. Welcome to our Friday finale broadcast about Santa Clarita Real Estate. We are, of course, headquartered in the SCV, serving greater Los Angeles cities with regard to real estate. I'm Connor McIver, your host. We do have a seven-day-a-week format, and it's very exciting today to present Friday finale. We're going to get into the real estate data. Then we're going to get into our Once Upon a Time in Real Estate segment, talking about writing offers less than the specific listing prices out there for real estate when you're approaching the buying venue for homes, condos, and townhomes. So that'll be our Once Upon a Time in Real Estate segment. Let's get into the local inventory. This is going to include the Santa Clarita Valley City, so we're going to cover Acton through Valencia, so we'll give those out as far as which ones specifically. Acton, Agua Dulce, Canyon Country, Castaic, Newhall, Saugus, Stevenson Ranch, and Valencia. For any other information for any other Southland city, send me an email, connor@paris911.com. You can go to our main site, paris911.com. Click on the shoot us an email button at the very top in the header, and you can do it that way as well. Send me the city. I'll get together the specific data so you can see exactly what happens to be going on in that particular area in and around Los Angeles. Rancho Cucamonga is fine. Anywhere in Ventura County is fine. Anywhere in the city of LA is fine. South of Los Angeles is good. Anywhere. Shoot it to me and I'll pull a very good detailed report so you can see what's going on, how those price trends happen to be working presently. Looking in, of course, Price Change Fridays, we're going to talk about the things that matter. And these are properties that are on the market, listed active for sale, which have their prices changed, and whether those are going to be increases or decreases. We'll cover that information and get into it. But first off, last 7 days here in Santa Clarita Valley, and we'll have a surprising number here in just a moment, but the last 7 days, we have 97 new listings that have hit the market for sale. If you want to see those, real simple, go to our main site, Paris, P-A-R-I-S, 911.com. Up at the top part of the screen, there is something called a Mac box, R development, and punch in the word new into the Mac box at the top part of paris911.com. When you do, then you'll see all of those new listings, and you'll be able to go through and verify and check and see, hey, is something like this might fit my criteria or not? Also, price changes 54. We'll cover that in just a moment. Are they up or are they down? Back on market properties 32. That's why you should always have your consummate real estate professional monitoring all the statuses. And we'll get into that in just a moment. Because 32 properties are under the BOM status. BOM stands for back on market. They fell out of escrow, folks. These are properties that were in escrow. They had executed contracts. Everybody had agreed. Might have gone back and forth with countering. You know, the buyers want a certain thing. The seller wants to ensure buyer's performance, so they reduce some kind of a time frame to give them the best advantage. All that was done. They were actually in escrow, and for the most part, there was money deposited in escrow as well. One of the things we found out yesterday, and I'll throw this out at you, agents sometimes don't explain to their clients how that escrow earnest money deposit actually works. And a lot of buyers in the world are scared they're not going to get it back if they happen to change their mind or find out if the property that they've written an offer on, had that offer accepted, went and wrote a check or had money transferred as per the agreement, whatever you agreed to with your agent. That money is this amount, whatever specific amount it would be, was going to be deposited within escrow. A lot of people are nervous that they're not going to get that back if they happen to cancel the transaction. It's not explained to the client. We had a case yesterday where we have a listing, and the agent that wrote the offer, their office didn't explain to the buyer that if you go in a few days later and something's going on and you don't want to proceed, you can cancel and your full deposit will come back to you. But nobody explained it to the buyer, so the buyer was now going to breach contract by not depositing money into escrow until the buyer waited for the home inspection, which was going to happen 3 or 4 days into it. And there's a short time frame when the money has to be deposited. And then people say, well, how soon are they going to get it back? They can't hold on to it, folks. Escrow has to give that money back. And it's going to be coming back within a day or two at the most. Have your agent explain it. That's why we have our crash course on real estate, so we can cover things like that. I think a lot of the people, some people out there in the sales profession, don't want people to know how easy it could potentially be to cancel the transaction because they want to get that check. Well, the way it should work is they should want to keep that client, and they should want to make that client happy, and that client will then talk about that agent, and that agent will become even more and more successful. Off the soapbox, 63 properties went into backup status, 2 expired, 55 went pending, 63 went sold. Here are the numbers, folks. Check this out. You backtrack 5 weeks ago, and preceding those 5 weeks ago, 2 years before that, we didn't breach 525 listings. 525 was about the maximum we were holding true with regard to for all of the Santa Clarita Valley cities. That was the maximum amount of properties we saw, 525 active. This morning, ladies and gentlemen, 640 active properties. And that's morphed and changed within the last 5 weeks. So that is good news for buyers out there. However, don't forget, there are enough buyers in the market. Even with 640 units, we're still not seeing an increase on days on market timeframes. We're still not seeing the market switch or change at all from being where it is today in a seller's market. The next couple weeks are going to reveal a lot of different things. School is going to be out. A majority of the Santa Clarita Valley schools, the 5th of June, 6th of June. The 5th is the Friday, so that's going to be the final day until school resumes. We're going to see a couple weeks, as we do every year, a couple weeks of parents taking kids around. Really not much going on in real estate as far as new inventory. Then it's going to start to move because people are going to start taking properties, putting them on the market because they're going to start moving up. There's still going to be a very high buyer demand because a lot of those sellers are also going to be, you guessed it, buyers. They're going to be buying real estate as well. So they can't sell their house unless they buy something else. But there's going to be a lot of entry-level buyers that are out here currently looking that are going to be able to pick up those residences. And there are going to be other people, empty nesters as well. We're going to have our fair share of that, people that are going to be even leaving Santa Clarita and Southern California, maybe going somewhere up north or somewhere out east to be closer to their kids. This is what typically happens every single year right around the same time, at least when we're in a normal, healthy market, not in a distressed market. And we are returning almost to a very healthy and robust real estate market. 640 active properties, 361 properties are in backup, 314 properties currently are in pending status. So that brings a grand total of 1,315 properties that potentially your real estate agent could be monitoring. We do that. Go to MLSBest.com, MLSBest.com, and search. You can see all of the active listings. You can see just active only. And you will not be steered away. Those are actual multiple listing service listings. And in fact, in order for us to publicize those on our website, we have to be licensed realtors, in good standing, a member of the local boards. We have to have approval to publicize those. And we have to be able to represent buyers and sellers of real estate. It all falls into place. That site is double checked with regard to accuracy, and it comes from the Board of Realtors, MLSBest.com. It's simple. I built it specifically for home search. You can also get home value there, and so on. Once upon a time in real estate, great, great buyer came to a real estate agent's door, sat down, the real estate agent covered with him the A to Z to real estate in something called a crash course. The buyer then understood. The buyer started viewing properties, and with the ones that he was interested in, he asked the agent, he said, Mr. Agent, is this a good price for this property? Well, the agent would then say, let me check. Because realistically, an agent can look at it and give you an idea. But until the agent sees the property is really going to be the point when they can give you a better idea as to what that particular value happens to be. And in some cases, as the agent explained to the buyer, it could be the seller wants too much for their property, thinks that the pool is going to add all the money they put into it, when realistically it might only add half of what they put into it, or a quarter of what they put into it originally. But it's going to depend on location, it's going to depend on time of year, it's going to depend on a lot of factors like buyer drive as well. So the agent went back to the office, did a comparable workup as all agents, good agents do when it comes to their buyers buying real estate, and show them the value. In this particular case, it was opined and determined via factual data that this property that the buyer was interested in was priced in the neighborhood of $20,000 higher than comps that had been pulled within the last couple months of sold properties, matching exactly with regard to square footage, bedroom, bathrooms, amenities, upgrades, and everything, straight across the board, about $20,000. So the buyer asked his agent, you know, what should I do? And the agent says, if you like the house, write an offer. Well, what should I write it for? Write it for comparable value and leave the rest up to me, as the agent said. Let me tell the listing agent where and why we are putting together an offer at this particular level and see what happens. Well, at the end of the day, the buyer did end up getting the property. The seller did come down $10,000, so the buyer met them halfway. The buyer was happy with that because, folks, properties don't stay static. And we could see a $10,000, $15,000, $20,000 increase in 1 month. It's going to just depend on the specific property and the appraiser that happens to be placed with regard to investigating that property and writing up an appraisal. So it does happen. Once upon a time in real estate, don't be scared to make offers less than list price when the facts back it up. And also make sure your agent has the intestinal fortitude to move forward with that listing agent and explain to them your why of making the offer at the level that you did. I'm Connor McIver, folks. Thank you so much for listening to our Friday finale broadcast. 54 properties had their prices changed, 4 increased in price. Majority of those are short sales. 50 were reductions in list price. More than half have less than 30 days on the market and reduced to the neighborhood of $5,000 to $15,000. This has been your Santa Clarita Real Estate Update. Thank you so much for tuning in. I am Connor McIver. All roads lead to our Paris911.com website. Paris is my partner in real estate. I was the 911 with LAPD for a long time. I appreciate you listening. It is my honor. I am Connor, over and out.